Welcome to Central Park.
And look at this one. The Ritz-Carlton Central Park. I've been looking super much forward to this one. Actually, just since we got here, this is our third hotel review in New York. And okay, welcome back. Okay, we are super excited about this one. I think it's going to be awesome. So let's go inside and have a look. And yeah, see you on the inside. Cheers.
See you. Guys, we have the Grand Parkview Suite and I'm so excited to see it. Come, it's just here. Not working. It doesn't. Dun, dun, dun. Ooh.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh. Oh, that view.
Oh yeah.
Look. Oh, I didn't even know Central Park was like this.
Oh man, if this doesn't take your breath away, then I don't know what will, okay?
It's just so much my style. It's really Vogue, fashion. It's just, I love it.
Ooh, bathroom.
Nice. Very nice.
Oh, that's elegant, eh? Hello.
Super elegant. Ooh, I don't know this one. What? Aspirin.
Okay, where do we go?
I want to see the bedroom. Isn't it cute? This is so cute.
I'm gonna film this view again here. Wow.
Another bathroom. This one is yours.
Oh, so we got two bathrooms. This is just with the shower and, oh man, with the bathtub as well. Oh, the Ritz-Carlton Yacht Collection. Maybe we can go there once, eh?
Yeah. Okay. Safe and closets. This is so Parisian style.
Okay, we need to do a recap right now.
Okay.
Initial impressions from our little suite tour. I mean, just coming into this suite was really a wow experience. One of the most iconic places and legendary places in the world, Central Park, right out here.
Yeah.
The service here is incredible.
It's really personal, I would say.
Very personal, yeah.
They're really helping a lot. I don't know how to explain, but it feels like they know everything about us and they...
Yeah.
They go beyond.
We are quite famous bloggers though. So, I mean, here they know everything about the guests. They try to get really close to the guests and you know, we talked to the manager. I mean, what do they actually mean by that? And he explained to us that, I mean, it's even if you're running out of toothpaste and you have a specific kind of brand or specific kind of toothpaste or whatever you need. Or if it's winter and they see that you haven't brought some warm clothes or something, they will go out and get stuff for you. And then all the staff here, all of them, all of the employees are exceptionally well trained. And it doesn't matter if you meet anybody in the outside, in the hallway, in the reception, in the whatever, everybody will be able to help you and answer your questions. It's not like, yeah, I have to send somebody or you have to be bounced around. No. Everybody knows what they're doing here.
Yeah.
The design and style. So the hotel have been through a major renovation and I think they just finished it last year.
Yeah, layout and design, I like, it's really Parisian. You know, the style, the walls. I don't know how you call this.
Moulure. No, stuk in Danish.
Stuk. I used to know in English, but the style is really Parisian. I feel like I'm in a Dior shop, for example, a Chanel shop.
Yeah. And we visited the lounge here, which is a unique experience. It's included when you book a suite. Otherwise, I think it's around for a couple. It would be around $300 access per day, which of course is expensive. But
worth it.
You get free food, you get free drinks, you get a view of the Central Park and a really nice place to relax. Yeah. I mean, super cool
ambience.
Just
on a day, if you take breakfast, lunch, dinner and champagne, it's covered.
Yeah. These guys know what they're doing, and it's a place that I can highly recommend anybody who ever comes to New York to go here.
Yeah, definitely.
Guys, I think we're gonna be off now. We're gonna go sightseeing and go around Central Park, or just go a small trip into Central Park.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for staying with us so far. We'll be back during nighttime in our pajamas and giving you the final first impressions of the day. So stay tuned. Cheers.
Cheers.
Wow.
Yeah, that's the word. Wow.
They know exactly how to make you feel at home and well. And
they remember names.
Yeah, so many names here. I mean, there are so many. I think there are many regular customers because they know pretty much everyone's name. And when we got back to the room here, they had this nice little. Now I don't know what that is. I'm gonna use it. I'm gonna carry this around with me. It's a picture of Central Park, if you cannot see it. So I'm gonna carry this around with me to polish my lens in all eternity. That's gonna be a really, really nice memory here.
It's the night service we had. So they closed the shades and we had some new amenities, some essential oil to sleep good and some cream for the eye, the lips.
Yeah.
And what else I can see?
Yeah, you really...
Yeah, a facial mist that I really like.
Yeah, it's luxury taken to a different level.
Yeah.
We went to the club lounge and we had amazing food. And the club lounge is not only good value, it's a steal. It's not cheap, but I mean, we had so much good food and they make cocktails for you free of charge. If you want champagne, fine. Scotch, single malt, fine. You want a cosmopolitan, fine. And
we
they
had some caviar.
They had caviar there. They had short rib. They had
scallops.
Scallops the size of an apple. I mean, what?
And the food was really good. I have to say, for
yeah, and it's just like small bites and desserts.
Very
and
elegant. Yeah.
Guys, I'm sorry, but you have to put this hotel on your bucket list. I know it's not cheap, but just put it on. Put it on there and go out here and try to visit these guys. You won't regret it, I promise you.
Yeah, it's a real experience.
Yeah, it is. So guys, we're gonna be off. We're gonna test the beds now and we're gonna tell you what we think when we see you in the morning. So I think that's it for now, right?
Yeah.
We're completely dead.
Yeah.
We did a lot of sightseeing also, so no more energy left. And
yeah, good night.
Good night, guys. See you tomorrow. Cheers.
See you.
Bonne nuit.
Bonne nuit.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Slept very, very well. this is a fret bed linen. Is it called fret? Frette?
Frette.
Frette. Frette.
It's German.
Frette.
Frette. Oh,
yeah. And the beds here are fantastic.
Super high quality.
Yeah. And thank you very much to the kind staff. It seems like they just keep on surprising us in a positive way. We thought it couldn't get any better, and then they just come up with some small surprise, or just, and just the way they treat people here. These guys are trained exceptionally well, but they also pick the right people, because you cannot train people to be nice like this. You know, you have to have some personality, some charisma, and stuff.
Definitely.
You just, yeah.
We met only great people. Only great people. In the lounge, the butler, the manager, they all have a special character.
Yeah.
And
I think I actually hugged someone. I think I gave someone a hug. So, no, it's really something. I feel like I'm both happy and sad, because I feel like it's just going to go downhill from here. The trip to New York has really, honestly, it changed my life. It's a dream I had since I was small. And coming here and doing these three hotels, and I mean, just here where we are now, for me, that's just unbelievable. So I'm incredibly grateful. And to share this with you.
No.
And with you guys, of course, because it's actually you who are making it possible. So otherwise, we wouldn't be able to stay in these kind of suites.
Okay, I'm hungry. We go to breakfast?
We go to breakfast. Guys, see you a little bit later. We're gonna check out the surroundings again, and we're gonna have some breakfast here and tell you what we think. And then we'll be back here with the final scores.
We're coming back from the spa.
Yeah. What a way to end this video and end our trip here to New York. Visiting the La Prairie Spa at the Ritz-Carlton Central Park. Just saying it is crazy.
And it's not a spa with the pool and everything, it's more like a treatment spa.
Yeah.
Even if you don't have any booking, you can just go use the steam bath, the La Prairie products for your face, and they have everything for your hair and everything at disposal. It's amazing.
Yeah, incredible products. That's really crazy stuff. And then, you know, as a fun thing, we did the Battle of the Slippers, because now we visited the three hotels, and St. Regis, Park Hyatt, and Ritz-Carlton, who has the best slippers. And I think in this case, the prize goes to, it actually goes to Park Hyatt for having the best slippers. Yes, it does. Okay, we didn't really,
we didn't talk about this. I like this one. I like Ritz-Carlton for the style.
Okay. We like all of them, very nice. But definitely the prize for the best robe goes to Ritz-Carlton.
Yes.
Yeah. Best robe goes to Ritz-Carlton. That's really something.
Yeah.
I mean, I would like to steal it, but they said like they're gonna bill us if we do that. So.
No, you can buy it at the reception. You can ask for it.
I'm pretty sure it's quite expensive. Anyway, what else do we have here? Oh yeah, we also did Battle of the French Toast, because for some weird reason we ended up ordering a French toast each day for breakfast.
Because it's quite heavy meal, delicious but heavy, and everybody knows I'm healthy and you're not. So you ordered all of them.
There were fruits on them. All of them had fruits.
Yeah.
And no, they were really, really good. All of them amazing. I mean, if you haven't ever tried a French toast before, just go try one. It's really good. Especially here. I think actually the Battle of the French Toast was won by St. Regis, maybe?
Yeah, because it was more crunchy.
Yeah, it's tiny details, because here at the Ritz-Carlton, everything is incredibly nice as well. But I do think, as we said before, go to the lounge and see the big selection of really, really delicious food they have.
Yeah, we went to breakfast at Contour.
Oh,
and
they
have a healthy corner with avocado. They have lots of... I remember everything. You can remember this. It's really delicious breakfast, but I would suggest more to go to the lounge, because it's kind of more cozy and you can try more things.
Guys, I think it's time for us to conclude this stay with putting up the scores and showing you guys what we think about our stay at the Ritz-Carlton Central Park. Britain, and you know, we don't have a fixed system that we use. Like if you have a spa, you have 10 points and you have this and that, or it's not like if you have 8 restaurants you get a higher score. It's really about the quality and of course also about the options you have, of course. Mm-hmm. But it's
and our feeling as well.
Yeah, it's very much, I mean, it's our personal feelings on the day. On this day we just had a fantastic stay. Guys, left and right, the scores here and the element, how we rated them. And summing up all of these numbers, the final score of the stay here is 968. I think maybe even topping the St. Regis by a point.
Yeah.
Mainly because the location here is
the view.
Amazing. The view is second to none. Yeah. Well done, guys. You really deserve, you know, I think this is the best score we've given so far.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be a while before we beat this one. Thank you very much for watching. We hope that you enjoyed this video. We definitely enjoyed creating it.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know where we're going to meet up next time, but we have some exciting locations planned. Mm-hmm. So we are looking forward to sharing this with you. But until then,
see you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Bye-bye.